Hello everyone, this is Alejandro, and in this tutorial we will see how we can use components to create objects that can be reused and can be changed while still maintaining a relationship with the original object. We will also see how we can use the same idea to create design systems in 3D and reuse different objects to create more complex structures. Components are very useful because they enable you to work faster by reducing the amount of time that it can take you to build complex designs, and they also enable you to work in a more efficient way because now you are able to create variations or iterate over your designs in a non-destructive way. Alright, let's begin. Alright, so I have a very simple scene here, which is a 3D icon of music. It's just a rectangle here. I'm just holding command and option to select the child objects of this container. And there is also a custom vector shape in here. And there is a text object here in the bottom. In order to create a component, you just need to select the object that you want to include in the component. And then you right click on the object and press on create component here. So now you see on the app liner, you will see that you have these four dots icon in green. And the way this works is that if you duplicate this object by pressing, let's say, command D or just, you know, command C and command B to paste, and then you move the duplicate, you will see a couple of things happening. The first thing is that a new object is created, but it's now called instance. And also the icon is a little different. It's just only two squares, and before it was just four, right? So an instance is a copy of this original object that maintains a relationship with this object here, right? So when I change this original object in any way, for example, like this, you will see that the instance is going to be updated automatically and in real time to reflect the changes in the original object, which is this. So I can also change the color. For example here, let's say that I detach this material, right? And maybe I can change the color. And you will see the change immediately there. And I can also change the text. So for example here, if I press and type different text, you will see that it's going to change. Now, the beauty of the components is that you can make changes to the instance in some of the parameters while still maintaining the reference to the original object in all of the other parameters. So for example, let's say that I want a different color here, I can change this to be a different color. So now it's a little bit more purple. And so I can do this very easily without making any other change in the main component. I can also add a bevel in here, so now this is using round corners, and then I can even increase the main corner's roundness to be maybe higher. Perhaps this could be maybe a little bit more like purple, for example. Now, if I change the main component, you will see that we still maintain the relationship in terms of size, because size is not being override in this object. Only the color and the bevel and the round corners were overridden, and all of the other parameters are still there. Let's make another duplicate of this object. So this will be our second instance. And in this one, we can change the round corner again. Maybe this time could be almost like a circle. I'm going to use the arc in here. Perhaps this could be maybe a little, almost like white, like this. And maybe a little bluish like this. We can also override the changes in the icon itself, maybe to be more like bluish. All right, now if I change the sizing here again, you see that we still maintain the relationship in terms of size. I can also change the text in here, so maybe this is gonna be just decent. And if I now edit this, so it will update the text in here, but it's not going to update the text in here because this one has a change in terms of text. But I can also change the size, and the size is not being overridden in any of them, so it will update the size in all of them at the same time. All right, that's how the main components work. Now let's see what else we can do with components. Now, if you modify the instances, you can actually create complete variations or full variations of your original object while still maintaining certain properties from the initial object. You can see in this example, all of these objects are actually instances of this main object in here. And if I change the size in here again, they still maintain the relationship with the original object. Even the circle, for example, which is actually a cylinder, if I change the angle in here, let's see if I can change here, you can see that it's updating the values in all of them because the cylinder also contains a parameter to create a hollow. So this one is using hollow, but this one is not. And that's why you can create this ring in here, while here is like a full fill. Let me just undo that change. Another cool thing is that you can also add interactivity to the main component, and the interactivity is going to be replicated in all of the other objects. So if I go to the play mode here, you will see that this one is moving, this is also moving, and this is also moving. But the interactivity was added only to this object in here. You can add events to components, and this is a lot faster than do it in the traditional way, because instead of adding an event to each individual object, you only need to add the event to the main component, and then all of the instances will replicate the same behavior. So I'm just going to select this container object from the main component, and then I'm going to add a new state. And in this new state, I just want to change the scale on the Z axis to be something like this. And after that, I just need to create a new event. And this event is going to be a mouse hover. So the mouse hover is going to have an action that is going to be a transition from the base state to the new state that is called state. And then the duration for this will be somewhere like 0.2 seconds. So now if I go to the play mode and I hover, you will see that this is working just fine. It's not only working here, it's also working in all of the other instances, because now they are inheriting the behavior from this component. So all of these emojis here are basically instances of this emoji in here. You can see that the main component here contains a lot of different variations that by default are turned off, and in the other instances you can toggle in like the ones that you want to see, and then you can toggle off the ones that you don't want to see. So this is like a nice trick to create variations of your components. Well, you can still maintain the relationship of the main shape. For example, this sphere is still the same in all of them, and you can change it, and all of the objects will use the same one, right? So now if we go to the play mode, you will see something interesting. And what is happening here is that we have an interaction that is added to the main component, and then all of the other objects are using the same interactions, but they behave individually, just like what we saw before with the clock. We see here with the mouse interaction. By the way, if you want to understand how this works, the arrow in here, which is like a cursor, is using a follow event that is sticking the object to the cursor in the browser. So when I go to the play mode, this object is moving. So that's how it works. You can also override the events on a particular instance to change the way it behaves. So right now, all of these instances, they behave the same as the main object, which is this one here. So what I'm going to do is to select this instance here, and then I go to the container, which is the object that has the states, and I want to override the second state because this is the one in which the object is rotated and on a different scale. So instead of going in that direction, I could put it on the other direction. And also maybe I can make this a little faster, so the hover event could be maybe like 40 units in the velocity. So now if I go to the play mode and I hover, you see that now that object is the only one that is behaving different. Now, components can also be used to create compositions like this. In this composition, we had a bunch of little cubes that together they create a bigger cube. But actually, all of these cubes are instances of this one in here. And this one is a subdivision object, so you can edit the shape. So for example, this is actually a subdivision object. And you can see that all of the other objects will update accordingly once I change this one. So if I resize this, for example, you will see that all the objects will resize also at the same time. So this is really cool because you can easily test ideas for your creations in a non-destructive way, so you don't lose the original changes. All right, so I can undo my changes in here. And you can see that the main component has a texture, but all the other objects are actually using different textures. So for example, here, this is using a different material and it's also using a different texture, and I can even disable it and I can change different parameters in here, like the lighting, for example. There is a lot of flexibility that you can achieve by just using instances. Now, components are very useful because you can also use them to create design systems. So this is a 3D design system, and you can see all of the elements in this 3D UI for a phone are actually components, and you can see each of them in here and how they are being used in this composition. If I go to the play mode quickly, you'll see that there's even interactivity happening in here, and if I hover here, this is what is happening. I want to show you another concept, which is the instance swapping. So basically, if you select an instance like this one, if you go here to the sidebar, there's this drop down that you can use to target a different main component. So maybe instead of product one, I can use product two, or I can use product three, right? So you can use a different main component for your instance, and then I can do the same here. Maybe this is going to be product one, right? So now we have this composition. In this example, if you go to the play mode and you click on the elements, you will see that all of them are treated in an individual way, because then again, all of them are just instances of the main component here. But another thing that you can do is that you can detach an object from each component. Like for example, I can click here in this icon, and then I can detach this icon, and now this object is going to be a normal object. This object is no longer referencing to this object, and instead this is just like any normal object. So when I go here to this component, for example, and then I, you know, resize this object, you will see that everything else is going to update except for this, because this is no longer a dynamic instance, right? This is now just a normal object. Another thing that you can do is that perhaps you actually want to revert the changes. So you want this object to be the same as this one, as it was at the beginning. And there are different ways to revert a change. And the first way is that you just go and click on the object. Like for example, I'm going to press Command and Option to select this child object. And then I can go here and press Reset Override. But I can also reset the material, so now it's going to be green, and then I can reset the geometry, right? So now it's going to be like this. You know, if you want, you can also reset just all of the changes. Like if I press here, it's going to reset all of the changes for this particular object. Now, another way is that you just click on the instance, and then you can reset all of the overrides in all of the children of this instance. So now it's gonna look exactly the same as the main object right here. So if I go to the play mode again, you will see that just look the same, right? Components can also be used in combination with the cloner system to add a variation to a specific instance of the clones. Here I have a cube with a cloner attached, and I can add a rotation to this clone, maybe like 10 degrees, to create this sort of helix in here. But I want one of these instances to have a different gradient. So I can click on this button that is called Convert to Instance. And now my first object becomes the main component. And then I have all of these other instances. Now what I want is this object in here to be a different color. So I just press Command Option and I click on this object in the viewport to select it. And now I just want to change this maybe to be a different color. Maybe this is like a little yellow instead. And you will see that that's the only object with a different color. But if I change my original instance, all of the objects will behave accordingly because they still maintain the connection to the main object. And I can also disable this object in here so it's not visible. Alright, that's how you can use components to create all sort of different scenes and reuse your objects to work in a more efficient and productive way on your 3D scenes, to create 3D design systems, to create icons, to create more complex structures. So you can use components in a variety of use cases. I hope you like this tutorial. Please let us know in the comments if you want to see more tutorials on this topic. Alright, see you in the next one. Bye bye.